Have you ever been to Gwacheon in Gyeonggi Province?
자, 우리 외국인 분들께 과천에 혹시 가보신 적이 있는지
네.
가보실 수도 있어요.
Sure.
뭐 국립현대미술관도 있고 여러 가지 또 관광시설이 있기 때문에 mm-hmm. 한번 여쭤보고 가서 가보셨길 기대를 네. 한번 해봅니다.
Okay, let's take you to Tell Me.
Tell Me!
Hi everyone, I'm Tommy on Tell Me, Tell Me. Now today for Unit 237, our question is, have you ever been to Gwacheon in Gyeonggi Province? Have you ever been to Gwacheon in Gyeonggi Province? Well, I have passed through Gwacheon on the subway. Have you ever been to Gwacheon in Gyeonggi Province? Let's go ask other people and see if they've ever been there. Let's go! Hi, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm great. What's your name and where are you from?
My name is Zara and I'm from Boston, Massachusetts.
Okay, Zara. Well, today our question is, have you ever been to Gwacheon in Gyeonggi Province?
No, I haven't.
Okay. Well, I thought you wouldn't have. Let me just briefly explain it. Gwacheon is a city that's right on the outside of Seoul, but it's still in a different province. So it's not Seoul, but it's right on the outskirts. And there are lots of museums and horse race courses there. And I was wondering, if you want to go to a nice museum, where would you go to in Boston?
I love the MFA. I'm a fine arts student, so the Museum of Fine Arts is awesome. They just opened a new American wing, so it's really interesting.
What are some places that you've been to? Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, I love it here. I mean, yesterday we went to Myeongdong.
Yeah, Myeongdong.
I love Namsan Park. It's right by my house.
Okay. All right.
And this is really cool, too.
Oh, the palaces.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was wondering, is it hard to find a place near the capital in your country, like near Washington, D.C.? Because Seoul is the capital of Korea.
Yeah.
And Gwacheon is right on the outskirt of Seoul. So mm-hmm. a lot of people tend to find it hard to find a place in Seoul. So what they do is they find a place in Gwacheon.
Oh, like a house?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So I was wondering, is there a place? Do a lot of people tend to live near the capital?
I think a lot of people that work in the capital live there. Okay. But there are a lot of suburbs like on the outskirts where people tend to live, I think.
All right.
I don't know that much about it, though.
Okay, and because Gwacheon is so close to Seoul, the streets are always jammed, there's always traffic, and it's really crazy. And I was wondering, is there a lot of traffic in Boston?
Yeah, people are like infamous for being terrible drivers there.
Oh.
And yeah, it gets really busy.
Well, you know, Gwacheon is also known to be a good choice to live in because it's right near the capital, yet it's in a different province, so there isn't as much traffic as there is in Seoul. And I was wondering, in the States, where is a good place to live in your opinion?
I actually love Boston. It has kind of a mix of like suburban and city life, which is nice. It's kind of a quieter, smaller scale city, you know? Easy to get around.
Okay, so last but not least, I know we're talking about Boston a lot. If you could live in one city, where would it be and why?
I would actually live, I think, in London, in England. My family's originally from England, so
okay.
I don't know. That's where I think I want to go.
We just talked to Zara from the States, specifically Boston. We talked about if she's ever been to Gwacheon, but she hasn't. But she is loving her stay in Korea. Well, I hope you guys learn a lot. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye!
자, 저희 기대하는 약간은 다르게 조금 아쉽죠? 과천은 뭐 다녀오신 적은 없으시고요.
Yeah.
근데 지금 한국에 살고 계신 분인 건 맞는 것 같아요.
맞아요.
She does live in Korea. Where is she from?
She is from Boston.
Mm-hmm.
And,
Massachusetts?
Yes. Zara, such a quite nice name. Mm-hmm. Museum, 자, 박물관, museum에 대해서 물어봤더니 저 버스턴에 있는 MFA에 대해서 이야기했었죠.
Mm-hmm.
A Museum of Fine Arts에도 해서 she's been there.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, she said she lives in Korea. 한국에 지금 사는 것 같은데요. 바로 어제 명동하고 또 mm-hmm. 남산공원을 다녀왔다고 얘기를 했었죠.
근처 사시는 것 같아요.
네.
I think she says those places are close to where she lives. 그렇죠?
Uh-huh.
That's what she said.
Uh-huh.
이제 뭐 현대미술관 때문에 미술관 물어보니까 혹은 뭐 박물관 물어보니까
uh-huh.
이제 버스턴에는 MFA라고 하는
네.
이제 자기가 좋아하는 박물관이 있다고 얘기를 하셨어요.
Uh-huh.
교통 얘기 물어봤죠? Traffic. I mean, uh-huh. traffic is really bad in big cities. It's not that bad in Gwacheon, but she says traffic can be bad in some cities in the United States.
Even Boston.
Even Boston.
Yeah.
버스턴이 어떤 도시냐 이렇게 좀 물어봤더니 mixed up city life, more smaller but quiet city 그랬었죠?
She said it's a suburban city.
그렇죠.
Yeah.
그러니까 약간 외곽에 있는 과천이랑 비슷한 것 같아요. 버스는 생각하면요. 사실 뭐 큰 대도시 이런 것보다도 약간 좀 규모는 좀 작지만 좀 조용하고 평온한 그런 도시의 어떤 성격을 갖고 있다고 얘기를 했었죠.
네.
근데 이제 저희가 다른 도시에 혹시 살고 싶으면 어디 살아보겠냐 그랬더니
런던.
부모님이 살고 계신 런던에 살고 싶다. 뭐 잉글랜드에 가고 싶다. 이렇게 얘기를 또 하시기도 하셨죠.
아.
자, 어쨌든 뭐 과천과 관련해서 여러 가지 질문들 또 함께 우리 뉴욕에서 오신 라라와 함께 나눠봤습니다. 그러면 마지막으로 저희가 표현 하나를 더 살펴볼 텐데요. 과천에 대한 이야기를 더 설명할 수 있는 표현 하나가 되겠습니다. 자, 오늘의 표현 만나보시죠. 자, 과천을요, 예를 들어서 가장 살기 좋은 도시 중에 하나이다 이런 얘기를 하고 싶으시다면 여러분이 살고 계신 지역과 같이 이런 문장 쓰셔도 좋을 것 같아요. 과천 is one of the best places to live in Korea. 자, 뒤에 전치사가 두 개 나왔는데요. live in, 자, 거기까지 끊어야 되고 한국에서니까 in Korea 전치사 두 개 나오는 게 맞습니다. 하나는 앞에 붙고 하나는 뒤에 붙는 거예요. 자, 그래서 과천 is one of the best places to live in Korea 해주시면 됩니다. 같이 한번 해보세요.
Let's practice two times. 과천 is one of the best places to live in Korea. 과천 is one of the best places to live in Korea.
뭐 서울 지역에서도 얘기해 줄 수 있을 것 같아요. 예를 들어 홍대라면 홍대 is one of the best places to live in Seoul 해주시면 되겠죠.
네.
자, 그 문장까지 마지막으로 여러분 잘 익혀두시고요. 오늘은 여기서 인사드려야겠네요. 저희 생활영어는요 홈페이지에 오시면 무료로 다시 보기 이용 가능하니까 많은 이용 부탁드리고요. 저희는 다음 시간에 찾아뵙겠습니다.
Alright everyone, take care and we'll catch you again tomorrow.
Have a great day everyone. Bye.
Bye-bye. I got joy.